forces, harde forces.
Stop being the badass that you are, and like literally not only one, not two, not three, not four, and not five. Like, he's taking all of the angels on by himself. He don't need none of this shit. He's got a cannon by his side, he's got his trusty old dragon slayer, and a lot of sheer dumb luck. Because if you think more and more about this, it's like, how the fuck he managed to actually survive a genuinely good amount of this stuff and all that he's dealing with, it's here I think impossible and all that for a normal human being to do it, especially in these two episodes of Berserk, I've got to say. So apologies for not redoing last week's one, but I definitely wanted to at least talk about both episode and 10 and 11 until we get the finale pretty much next week, which is going to upset me more and more, because even though, like, you know, Berserk 2016 has got a ton of problems, like, just so many, like, you can name off it, like CGI, like character designs and all that, like, go a little bit off and all wanky like that, like, just frame to frame and all that looks fucking horrible at some points, and like, any of the frames per second like that is just not really that great and all that. But it's like, even still, like, these two episodes and all that, I really did have a goddamn good time with and all that. And let's just go straight in to immediately one of my favorite moments and all that. And it's in episode 11, I just want to mention first. And that's when we saw Skull Knight after, like, he was, like, crossing there. And he saw fucking Zod right at that start of that episode. Oh my god, when we saw that, it's like, round two of fucking both Skull Knight and, like, Zod after all this time. You see him and it's just like, oh, literally got super excited seeing, like, him again after all this time. Like, it's like, oh, I've missed you, Zod, you fucking crazy ass bastard. And it's like, what have you been up to since then? But meanwhile, like, during the, like, going back in a little bit to, like, episode 10 and all that, we did get to see a good chunk of that where we sort of, like, when immediately when we got to see, like, the whore, like, come down there, and she was literally, like, found out by the egg or, like, apostle, and he was like, you know, like, he was explaining kind of his backstory. I was like, I never had anywhere to go for and all that as a kid. I was, like, thrown down, like, this quartz pit. I was eating rats and, like, God knows what else. And, like, I tried to come up there and all that, and it's just, like, by day and all that, like, when I tried to get out there, like, people just used to throw rocks at me thinking I'm a monster and all that. And by night, I, like, hid. And when they started throwing the corpses down here with me, I actually got crushed by corpses. And it's, like, because of due to the amount, like, you know, like, the breeze and all that threw down there. And it's, like, he was buried under a bunch of corpses, not being known by anybody like that at that point. And I'm like, wow, that's fuck. That you think about that, it's like, that's fuck, not even being known. And he's like, I didn't even have a name or anything. And it's like, just as I'm about to die, I had a bailet. And it's just like, his wish for the entire world and all that, like, after he met the five angels, it's like, my wish for all of this and all that is to actually, like, be the egg for the new world. And he just looks like a bailet, and he's just like, I'm gonna use this. And, like, he is the catalyst, and he is the thing that's gonna help, like, change the world, as we can clearly see with, like, the God Hand awakening and, like, the actual Tower of Conviction looking like the God Hand itself. And it's just like, you can see when, like, Guts is, like, fighting the angels, like, throughout the entirety of the episode, like, even once he's dealt with them, he saw, like, the depictions of, like, all of them. Like, you got to see Void and Slan, like, all the rest of them, like, all coming up there. And it's just like, you're seeing the God Hand appear in front of him throughout all of this. And it's like, he's going fucking nuts. He's like, I haven't got time to deal with this shit. Even with, like, dealing with all the angels, which was a goddamn hard-ass time for him as well, as he's able to, like, fight off, like, the giant, like, angel that's slamming him through concrete. He's got ones, like, throwing feathers at him, trying to pull his eyes out, trying to, like, chain him together. And it's just like, this guy is barely doing this by brute strength at this point, doing this. Even with, like, the fucking weird crow guy and all that, it looks like he belongs in Bloodborne, throwing, like, for, like, even all these feathers at him and all that. And it's just like, Guts is, like, barely able to stand, but he's like, no, I've just got to keep going. I've got to get Casca. Got to say that as they're trying to execute her right as this is going down, it's like, we need to do this immediately. I love, like, how, like, you know, with, like, Serpico like that, he's just like, he's like, wow, this guy's really strong and all that. And then Farnes is just there in a corner just crying. Like, no, I don't want to deal with this or that. And it's like, and even when they're, like, talking to, like, Mogus and all that, he's, like, got his angels and he's just like, look at me, everyone, burn the the witch noir. This is God powers incarnate. It's like, no, dude, you're a fucking demon now. Like, you don't even know. Like, the sheer irony of, like, what exactly, like, they have turned you into and all that, like, after everything, is like, what that guy did to you. And it's like, he is not, like, he's, like, willing or, like, he just doesn't know. He has control of it. And then even when, like, he transforms even more into, like, the fucking rock form, and he's like, oh, it was the Bible that saved me, that gave me this power. It's just like, no, it's just, like, what happened was, it's just that your goddamn strong-ass rock body protected you, not the Bible. And it's just like, and even when you think about, like, how Guts was able to beat this fucker, is literally just by, like, just sheer repeating stabbing and swinging at this guy, even though taking his god thousand strike and just wrecking him and all that. And it's just like, I haven't got time to worry about this guy. I'm trying to deal with the fucking twin angels at the back. And as well, I've got to go and rescue Casca before she's set on fire. Luckily, though, Lita, though, actually managed to, like, help her and saying, like, no, I'm going to actually save, like, Casca and bring her back up there. And even as well, the knight up there, which, like, I like how, like, Park Isidro and that knight dude actually use a combination to fuck up the twins. And it's like, no, let's get that and get Casca. Let's bounce out of here and all that while we got a chance. And just, even when you think about, like, how, like, Guts beat here, like, Amogus and all that, he literally just, shoved the sword just so far, marched up his chest at that point, where he's like, oh, I'm gonna take you with you, and even as I'm gonna take you, like, with him, grab you, he just literally lifts up this, like, hundreds of thousands of pounds of just pure rock, and just, like, swings it down there on the floor, and he's like, well, there you go, problem done, like, that is, the eclipse is still happening, it's like, shit. And it's like, well, wait a minute. Now when we think about it, he's looking at it saying, look how everyone's like near this, like the corpse of him and is on fire. Wow, wait a minute. Like, you know, fire doesn't work against these guys. You know, they're pretty weak too and all that. And it's like, all we got to do is survive till like sun. And I like the fact that it's like, even everyone who's describing it, Skull Knight, everyone is just like, we're not winning this. Like, this is not a happy ending regardless. However, the best outcome after this is living another day after this shit. After this giant fucking catastrophe that has happened. And I'm just like, okay. Then it's like, so that's definitely kind of like where like the series is going and all that, the final episode. Like, but definitely I gotta say and all that, like the one bit I had probably an issue with, like maybe a late last part of the episode and all that, when we saw like was Guts and all that on like an episode level, which probably when he came out of the slime and he was like slamming Mogus to the like the fucking ground and shit like that, and he had like this all the goo just coming out and it looked like he had fucking jelly on him and that, it just looked super fucking weird and all that. Although like it's a shame because I love that scene regardless in the manga, like, and I do love the bit when he just slams into the fucking ground when he just grabs the dragon slayer and try pins him in the light. Everyone's like, oh, there's a great angel, the black demon, and like Guts has literally got smoke on him because he's like been fucking burnt and charred and all that, and he's just barely holding on. It's just like, and the weirdest thing is like when he saw like on the egg and all that, the apostle, and he's just like, I saw like the baby there, I saw the child there, and it's like, you know, in there, and it's like, what the hell is the fuck is up with that? And it's like, yeah, like, what is that? Like, I think people will have to put their own little answers in the comment section or whatever they think it down below, but it's like, you know, like, what that is all about there. But overall, like, definitely, like, it's weird, like, because the show's CGI got better. Like, I do think Mogus, when he sees you, when his transformation happened, I still think it looks fucking terrible. I think it looks horrific. But then again, it looks better than his normal version. Because even when he looked like a normal guy, he looked like a fucking Lego man. Like this one now, he just looks like a PS2 villain now. That's just all how he is. But it's like, it's just overall, I'm looking forward to like last episode or so, like Berserk and all that. But install, I'm gonna miss it regardless. Like I know that, but it's like, you know, I just, you know, there are some things you, like that you can't have in this world. And one of the things I would have wished for is that we could have had a better though adaptation. But you know, we can't help that and all that. So let me know you guys in the comments down below what you think about this episode. But that's all for me. So I will see you beautiful bastards. So next time.